ever. Here's Tom. Tom, you're on Run a Fez.
Yeah, hi, guys. I'm co-chairman of the BWW, which is Bad Wigs for Workers, and we're trying to raise awareness for people with bad wigs. I wondered if Fez, you wouldn't mind wearing one.
Fez, would you like to become the face of the wiggers in 2007?
I wouldn't mind putting on a bad wig just till I get a little bit more stubble on the roof there.
Do we got any wigs around here at all that Fez can put on?
We're fresh out, Mr. B.
I thought there was a couple laying around.
I'll check.
Remember you had one on one day? It was fun. We were all enjoying them.
Get that red wig.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. We'll try and find that one.
Who's we? Because I haven't seen you move yet.
Me and,
Leon Marshall.
Me and my nutsack. That's who's going to take care of this. Me and my nutsack.
Those guys are so funny. When they said me and my nutsack, I almost died.
You know, you don't get a lot of nutsack humor on the radio.
Walt, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Yeah.
Just wanted to echo what the first guy said to you, but this year you've been really awesome. I've enjoyed the show.
Oh, thank you.
But yesterday was a hell of a lot better when Ballpark was on. I don't know why Fez is back, but Ballpark was almost as cool as Big A.
Ballpark is the coolest. That's one of Fez's many characters.
I don't have a character named Ballpark, and it's not even a cool character because it's not like a baseball nickname.
Right.
It's a nickname from having so much neck fat that it kind of folds up like a package of Ballpark Franks.
Witty.
I don't think so.
All right, put on your wig and see how that looks.
This wig is actually nice because it's kind of like a knit hat inside.
Oh, nice.
So it's almost like putting on a hat.
I can't believe how much you look like Eastside Dave right now.
How do I look as a redhead?
That's just very upsetting. I don't have that many curls. Did I?
That looks exactly like you.
Oh. It's me, your Uncle Dave.
Not gay,
you're my namesake. You were named after me. Don't forget to introduce me, your baritone boyfriend. Are you ashamed of your gay baritone uncle? Thank you.
Look, you just did an impression of yourself.
Oh, yeah.
You're the one who does thank you. Here's Tom. Tom, you're on Run a Fez. How are you, buddy?
Good. About you?
Don't worry about me.
Hey, I want to know if Fez would do me a favor since it's Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
If I send him a check for $7, will he put me on as the beneficiary for the insurance on the plane flight so when it goes down, I get some money?
No, I'm not going to do that. It's not going to happen.
Come on, it's Christmas.
Yes, it's Christmas. Don't wish me dead.
They used to have those things at the airport where you could buy insurance from a little machine at the airport.
That's right. It was like an insurance vending machine.
And then finally the airlines went, you know what? This is really bad.
It's a downer. It's not helping people as they're boarding.
Maybe I better get that. Like a lottery ticket in case it comes in.
Every flight back then must have been like a 50-50 chance of just making it if there's flight insurance available right there before you board.
Jeremy, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, buddies. Happy holidays.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I just wanted to comment on the movies, Rocky Balboa and We Are Marshall. I would not want to waste my time ever again. I wish I could get back the 2 hours that I spent watching Rocky Balboa. I like We Are Marshall way better. I think Stallone really needs to, go back into the well for another good movie.
See you later. Has he made a good movie since the first Rocky?
I don't think so. I don't think there's been a good one since.
What about Paradise Alley, Fez? I thought you would have been into that in a big, big way.
That one, I enjoyed Terry Funk's work in it, but not Stallone's.
You know, I was on cable the other day, remember that awful movie Fist, where he did the band?
Oh, yeah.
It's like this big, sweeping epic, and he's aging, and he's supposed to be in his mid-60s, but he still has the big Rocky arms.
It was Jimmy Hoffa.
Yeah, and they gave him the name Johnny Kovacs or something, but it was just blatantly Jimmy Hoffa. It was just such an awful movie, and he had the dramatic chops of a ham sandwich.
Mike, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, Ron, now that Opie's hanging out with Matthew McConaughey, how long do you think it's going to be before he's going on TV shows or going on the air, stone to the bone?
That's what I'm worried about.
Was last night.
You know, Anthony, I figure, is always going to be Anthony, but it looked like Opie in front of us was turning a little California. Just him and Matthew McConaughey enjoying themselves. I'm sure they went back and played bongos. And it just seemed like Opie is ready to embrace the California lifestyle.
Yeah, and just when we talked to Opie last night on the show,
yeah,
Opie was already just lit from the margaritas.
He was lit. He was happy. He said for the first time of his life, he knew what it felt like. You know, to finally be happy. He loves that lifestyle.
Yeah, and was telling us about walking down the streets in L.A. and California.
Well, no, he dropped Melrose. It was just,
right.
You know, I'm walking down Melrose, and you could just tell that he finally got what he considers the Long Island stank off him and back to where he should have been born, Beverly Hills.
Yeah, it was just coming a little too natural to him, just fitting in a little too nicely.
Here's Scott. Scott, you're on Fez.
Hey, buddy, season's greetings.
Same
I just
you.
Want to say, you're talking, thank you. Stallone was great in Nighthawks, and that took right place in Fezzi's yard.
Oh, yeah, that's right, Roosevelt Island. This is the first big Roosevelt Island film.
Yeah, it takes place, I guess there's a kidnapping on the Roosevelt Island tram, and I think Carl Weathers is in that movie, too.
As he should be. Now, I see Bobo's here, Tom the Cop is here, and I also see Stalker Patty back there. So, over the next couple hours, Fez will be able to say hello to everybody. Coming up next is Polo. Let's take a break right now, and we'll be right back. Merry Christmas from Ron and Fez.
Ron and Fez, XM 202.
From the legendary Ron and Fez studios in a predominantly white neighborhood, Ron and Fez presents Showtime with the Polo.
Hey, Polo, you like the movie.
Polo, you like the movie. How are you today?
Polo, you like the movie.
Merry Christmas. Happy New Year.
Same to you, Polo. You're going to be excited. This is the Christmas time of the year, and it's all Oscar buzz, right?
All Oscars. I'm getting prepared. I'm trying desperately to figure out a top 10 list. I've got a lot of holiday movies to deal with, you know, that are going to be out the next couple of weeks. You know, I'm just in a, you know, kind of a tizzy.
Well, we'll deal with your top 10 list when we come back early in January, because that way you'll have a chance to see everything.
Yeah, well, and not only that, I'm still, you know, really pulling my hair out.
You're not sure? You don't even have a favorite film of the year.
I do have a favorite film of the year, but I'm just saying that I'm going through everything, like every bit of movies, you know, because I don't want to get into the lemming mentality, you know, the sheep mentality, a lot of critics, where they all just name the same things because they don't know. They just want to reinforce their own opinions. I really want
That's how Fez is. That's you just described Fez. He goes, I've come up with my top 10 list because I've just read two. What's coming out over the next week, Polo?
All right, well, we've got a lot of things. We've got Rocky Balboa, we got Dreamgirls, we got We Are Marshall, The Good Shepherd, Letters from Iwo Jima, Venus, Night at the Museum, Children of Men, Home of the Brave, Pan's Labyrinth, The Curse of the Golden Flower. These are some of the things that are coming
out. Is anything worth seeing? They all sound quite awful.
Well, first of all, the Rocky Balboa, I never liked any of the Rocky movies.
Even the first one?
I didn't like the first one all that much, no. And I like this one.
So, for some reason, you like the sixth in the franchise.
I knew
the first that you cared about.
I knew he'd come around.
No, because, I mean, what it is that he's really had time to evaluate what he accomplished and what that whole thing was. Stallone, you know, has been floundering for years. That's obvious. And he really has shocked me almost with the amount of commitment he brought to the role this time.
And this was very low budget, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, he was...
What do you think they spent on this film?
All I know, it was very shaky through the whole process. He was very worried that it would ever get finished. And so, I mean, you know, yeah, the budget was clearly a concern. There's no name actors. That they brought Burt Young back, which, of course, they needed to do. A big part of the movie is his grief over the death of his wife.
Why ruin that for us? I haven't seen it yet.
Well,
I'm not going if Adrian's dead.
So, I mean, you know, it's all about reevaluating your life, and you know, I mean, it's not the greatest,
Patty.
It's not Death of a Salesman, but it almost approaches it. It's that kind of an approach, almost.
Yes.
And then the fight scene.
Death of a Boxer.
Pretty effective. But I mean, Antonio Carver is the fighter that he challenges, who's a much younger fighter. And it kind of hinges on those computer games that they did with Muhammad Ali and, was it Rocky Graziano or somebody?
No, it was Marciano. Hey, Stalker Patty just stopped in. How are you, Patty?
Hi, how are you?
Did you see your boys on TV last night?
They were great.
Yeah. Were you waiting for your name to get mentioned?
No.
I was. I kept going, mention Stalker Patty. Come on, Aunt. Do it. When he was doing Patty impressions, I was hoping he was going to do a Patty impression. Hey, didn't you feel sorry for Aunt, too, when it's just like, I hear you do an impression of, he was just like shoving them into the bluntness of it.
Oh, yeah, yeah, just right there. And then also when someone that you do an impersonation of says, hey, do me.
Yeah.
It's just even more on the spot than anything else he was doing.
It doesn't like, didn't let him work it in, just said it, but he killed with it. Patty, you brought us some Starbucks presents?
I sure did.
Hey, Patty, what is your movie of the year?
I don't know. I just go to Blockbuster. I don't go to the movies.
You sound exactly like Paul O.
I go to the very front row every single time. I love the movies. I love the big screen. I love to be enveloped by the movies.
I don't love the $10 admission fee.
Whoa! Nice one, Patty.
Let's face it, Patty. If somebody took you to the movies, you'd enjoy it, wouldn't you?
Wow.
If someone took me to the movies, I would enjoy it.
Are you offering, Paul O?
No. As you know, I've been involved at this point, but
that's right. You're married.
You
mean a new girlfriend? Not think you're going to cheat on her as well after 25 years?
First of all, she knows full well what I've been through, the hell that I've been through, and the hell that you guys and you guys know the hell I've been through.
Oh yeah, I know.
I know, yeah, but yet now you're acting like the hot to trot divorcee.
Yeah.
I'm not, but I had to go through big sessions with the doctor, and the doctor was saying, right in front of Gail, he was saying, you know, be grateful that he's saving his own life. You know, he's telling Gail that right there, because basically she's been killing herself and me for years.
Oh, I know that, too.
Can't he prescribe a pillow to put over her face?
Is she so mad at you right now?
Well, no, it's more that, you know, we were having these sessions, and it's all about her dependency and my codependency and my enabling that allowed her to take all the pills and the alcohol and everything else. And she's, if anything, I mean, we kind of think she's a sociopath who, you know, who's going to not really care about anything except the fact that she's not going to be able to do her old behavior, you know, whatever.
Well, here's the thing, though. How come you're now listening when I've told you this for years?
Because because you weren't there to hold me or something. I don't know.
I told you flat out kill her. How many times?
Okay. Well, in any case, we'll get back to that.
Do you feel bad about it a little bit?
The thing that I feel bad about is that I failed after 31 years, you know, to do anything. And it took the fact of bringing us to the brink of destruction and, you know, before somebody managed to pull me out before it was all over.
This lovely woman, this beautiful, lovely woman.
Yes,
Bobo's here. Bobo, are you disgusted by his behavior?
Just filthy.
Yeah, I know.
Reprehensible. I'm appalled, sir.
Sometimes when you're with your new girlfriend, you're like, I wish Gail could see this.
You want to know her name?
Yeah, I do.
Hey, Paul.
You can say it. Melly is okay.
Melly.
Melly.
Hi, Melly. Shout out.
Hello, Melly. You know her, Bo?
Yeah. We spend a lot of time on the ronfez.net chat room now.
And what's she like?
She's very funny, very sweet, big Elton John fan, big Monty Python fan, and she loves saying, pee in my butt.
What? Now, what does she say in Paul?
You know, never having actually seen Paul, yeah. I don't know.
I feel terrible about Gallo, don't you, Fez?
I think it's just awful, especially at the holiday season.
Oh, just the...
Well, she's going to be in the hospital with...
She wants to die before Christmas.
That's true.
And she's afraid.
Is she dreaming of the White Hospital?
That was in August. But you'll have group sessions and everything, you know. It's really, we're just going to try and keep her out of jail once she gets out. But in any case, you know, there are lots more movies to talk about.
And I would love for her to live with Fez for a while.
Yeah, if that was possible, that would be just, Fez or Earl, either one, you know, Earl is good too.
Sure.
I mean, because, you know, he sort of likes that.
Here's a song dedicated to Gail from Paul O.
Listen to this. Please don't take drugs.
She's not happy.
everybody.
She's so lonely. She's got no one left to lose. She wants to die before Christmas.
Do you hope to die before Christmas?
I hope so.
She's afraid.
I'm afraid that if I die before he will. And I think what's going to happen is he won't care at all.
He won't care at all that you're gone.
I'm gone.
I'm gone.
I'm gone.
Probably going to commit suicide.
If you die first, I probably will commit suicide.
Don't do it. Don't do it. Do it. Don't kill yourself. You're someone else. Kill Paul. You'll have to do it while he's sleeping. Hang bang, shoot him in the head while he's laying in bed. You can blame the medicine.
The biggest problem is that she doesn't understand exactly how mentally ill she is.
I am not that mentally ill. I have a bipolar disorder.
It's nothing.
It's not.
It's a bipolar on top of a schizophrenia.
No, I'm not schizophrenic, Paul. I'm dual. You've heard of what I'm saying.
Yes.
That's it. The doctor.
Dual personality.
Yeah, you know. Taking you the pill. I'm not psychotic, Paul.
So sad. She knew this was coming. She knew that he was going to do this.
Does Paul go to the movies a lot to get out of the house?
Yeah, he does.
I escape into the screen, you know, it's like, you know.
Yeah. All right, Paul.
It's a beautiful song, too. That's like the song Pink Floyd should be making now or something.
Hey, Jim, you're on with Paul O.
Hey, Paul, you turn around and force her to have two abortions, and then you abandon her in the holiday season?
Unbelievable.
You suck, Paul.
Yeah, that's
well,
a good point.
You got to understand is that this thing I've been saying for 30 years, and essentially, this is probably the best thing for anybody. Because we were going to like a bit.
It's the best thing for you, isn't it?
Yeah, you ought to just put two fetuses in a stocking and send to her at the home.
All right, Patty, what did you get Fez and I for Christmas here?
This is for you.
Oh, thank you, Patty.
And this is for you.
Thank you, Stalker Patty.
Isn't this lovely, Fez? Like a little Starbucks. Look, it's a nice love thing.
It's gingerbread cookies.
Gingerbread cookies. Oh, that's fantastic.
And I got you each a $5 gift card.
Oh,
enjoy
thank
your latte
you.
On me.
Oh,
thank
I will.
You.
I'm going to have a latte on her, Fezzy.
I got a bag of the Christmas blend coffee. And, Ronnie, I can use this to, when I travel here. Yes. It looks like my gift card comes like in a luggage tag.
Sure it does. You can actually stow that now if you need to.
Yeah.
Bubba, I saw you brought your little ukulele along. I don't know what it's called. What is it exactly?
I'm trying to break the world's record for carrying around an instrument nonstop.
I see it with you constantly.
Yeah.
Well,
I don't have to be consistent with what the instrument is, but I have to carry an instrument with me wherever I go for the next 3 years.
What is this?
This is called a charango. It's actually a South American ukulele.
Mm-hmm.
I used to eat those at Taco Bell.
That's good. All right, nice. You want to play a little tune for us?
Because
Paulo doesn't seem to care about the movies. He's not.
Oh, I do, but I mean, I can.
Why are you
do the
screaming?
Movie reviews while he. Okay, but yeah. I can do the movie reviews while he plays.
Oh, you want to do that?
Okay.
He'll play a little bit, and you can do movie reviews.
Let me.
And try to sing them, would you, Paul? Sing your reviews.
Okay. I'll
yeah.
Play.
It's a little Christmas season here with Ron and Fez. This is our last show before we go on vacay. All the buddies are stopping by. So far, the nicest thing I got, Fez, is this coffee from Stalker Patty.
We have actually been trying to put up my reviews to poetry. We do haiku reviews.
Oh, yeah. You want to do some haikus like that?
Well, I was told by Melly that haiku reviews are not...
Now he's ready to drop the Melly name so easily after he got outed by
he's
Bubba.
He's been holding out for how long, and now it's the only thing coming out of his mouth.
Well, I was told when I had written a bunch of haiku reviews that she said, no, they have to be 5-7-5, dumbass.
What were you doing?
I was just doing, like, free verse.
Oh, you did free verse. Go ahead.
Okay.
I'm not ready. But
sure, go ahead.
We Are Marshall is a film that is just like Invincible because it's about people who are trying to struggle, and it's losers who somehow persevere. And The Good Shepherd has got an icy performance by Matt Damon. It's very deep into the spy world, which Robert De Niro seems to love obsessively.
Did you like that one, Paulo?
I liked it, but of course you have to buy into the fact that this is going to be a dry spy movie. In other words, it's all going to be about the real spy world, which is very not James Bond. I mean, it's just
right.
People playing little girl games and the Skull and Bones games that, you know, just come out of that. Because obviously George Bush.
Hey, Randy, you're on with Paul O.
Looks like Gallo's going to be all Stallone for the holidays.
Oh.
Everybody's going to be in my film.
So
sad. Gallo, so, you know, everybody has a shot at the Oscars next
year.
You're
like Woody Allen. You will work with your ex-wife. That's really,
yeah,
really cool.
Yeah,
of you.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. No, you fell in love on set.
No, we were very, very close for a long time before we ever met.
Hey, looks like we've got a big New York opening lined up for you, Paulo, but you have to do reshoots and re-editing?
No, I have to do a money shot with No Filter Paul.
What went wrong there?
No,
would you
it
say
was,
it's his acting or your directing?
It was actually the equipment, because, you see, the first day was just a half a day with him, and we didn't have the effects guy, which came the next day, so we didn't get the real bloody stuff done. So we need to have a shot of him really, like, screwed up, fucked up. We also saw the East Side Day footage, which I think he's really got great screen presence. I wouldn't mind doing some more with him, but I actually love what I have, so I have to get a release from him. And then,
now, that's where he choked himself?
Yeah, it was actually funny. It was actually very convincing. I actually loved the way it looked.
Where he was his own killer.
Well, believe me, I there are a couple of things I have to cut from it. It's not very long. That's why I'd like to do some more. But, I mean, the fact is I think he has a very effective screen presence, and I think he did a great acting job considering the circumstances.
I wonder.
I'm serious. But, I mean, I'd like to open the film with it. But in any case...
Do we have an exact date on this theater yet? What's going on, Earl?
It's all on Paul O now. Finish the film, and we'll pretty much get the ball rolling on anything.
Yeah,
do you have the theater lined up?
The Anthology Film Archives, they are definitely interested in the film and in the premiere.
You had said we should shoot for around Oscar time, around the...
Well, I thought it might be fun if we did it Oscar time, and then we had a red carpet event. If not, we can push it back to spring.
No, but I think I can get it done. I mean, I'm going to start getting it, the final edit done after New Year's Day.
I definitely want a red carpet event.
Oh, I totally want to walk the red carpet for this thing, for Gap.
And I'm thinking of this other place, if we don't do it there. There's a place in Tribeca that I went to for the Tribeca Film Fest that has a bar. It's two theaters with a bar in between them, and... it would be very, very cool to hang out there.
Isn't that the place that De Niro owns?
It could be. If it's in Tribeca, he owns half the things down there.
Yeah, half of Tribeca, exactly. So, I mean, yeah. And he's really obsessed with the CIA. De Niro really did a great job. But
would you like to do a twin bill with him? Would that be something, or it's got to be just
you
yourself?
I could live with that. Yeah, I think I could live with that. Something I could...
No, you don't want reviewers there, right?
No, it's not so much that I don't want the reviewers there, but I want them to enter into kind of a complicity with me. So they would no longer become reviewers, but maybe potential victims.
Cheerleaders.
Fans.
Yeah.
Something like that. But, I have no real problem. They can basically do what they want, but they should just realize there are consequences to their actions, that's all.
See, I can't I can't invite them, then, because that's a threat.
I'm not saying that.
Hey, Keith, you're on with Paul Lowe.
Hey, Merry Christmas, guys. I miss Drunk Fez.
Me too. He was
the
best.
Hey, Paul, are you afraid Santa's going to come down your chimney and smother you with a pillow for what you did to Gallo?
No, I mean, I think Santa understands completely. And I think he's, if anything, what we all need to do is all pull together and find out how we can help Gallo. Maybe Fez and Earl and Ron will all take her up there and
gang bang.
You know,
crazy gang bang.
No, remember.
Take it back to the clinic?
No, yeah. But I'm just saying, you know, it shouldn't all rest on my shoulders.
Where will you be Christmas Day, Paulo?
Probably Christmas Eve, I'll probably have to go over to the hospital. But Christmas Day, I want a break.
Is that you and Melly?
Yeah, Oh, yes, I suppose.
Will you guys be laughing like, we put her away in the nut hut? Now we're in our love nest.
Let's toast our champagne.
In and out of the nut hut as well. You know, this was the first time that she agreed to go in on her own, which she even did before we got into in-depth.
Is there any way we can talk to her for Christmas, Paul?
What?
Just give Gail a call for Christmas.
No, she won't be able to take calls today. I mean, seriously. Maybe after the holidays we can consider this.
You can't, this will be out. You can't answer the phone in the straitjacket, can you?
No.
Not with those shackles on.
No. Now, the problem is she's supposed to be off all her drugs, but you know she's going to be doing everything she can to manipulate to try and get more drugs.
Sure, with you putting them under her tongue. Here, sleep, my pretty, so I can go off to my love nest.
So, but that's not going to happen anymore because all of that's over. I mean, you know, basically.
You'll never live with her again.
That's the idea, yeah.
Are you living with Melly now?
Yeah, that's what we basically.
Whoa! In your house or hers?
In hers.
Mm. Wow.
You don't want to share Gail's bed with her.
Love Shack.
No, that's
Love
not
the, Shack, baby.
The point is that, I know everybody was kind of rooting for my death, and I'm sorry.
Just the opposite. This is what I always wanted to happen.
I mean, you know, literally, I'm being saved from the jaws of death. And so is Gail, frankly.
Oh, yes, it's good for her, too.
Oh, yes.
It is.
Right.
You know how many
for her.
Times
Christmas
I found
in the nut house.
Do you know how many times I found her when she was so out of it that literally her eyes were open? She looked dead.
And she wouldn't die on you, would she?
Because the point was, this was her own doing.
Mm-hmm. It's
and I
her
was
fault.
Enabling. Well, I was helping. I was helping, but I shouldn't have helped. That's my point, so I'd stop helping.
Yeah.
Brother,
I'm on your side.
I hope Melly never has a day where she gets a little depressed or something.
She better be looking over her shoulder for the new kid in town. I'm telling you, within 31 years, he'll want to throw you away. 31 years, as long as he can stay.
She already knows I'm a wreck of a man. I'm basically a shell of myself. She's trying to see if there's anything salvageable here. There's, you know, she already knows that I you know, she's piecing together what's left.
Bubble, how are you doing for the holidays? I know you swing up and down with, you know, how things are going.
Yeah, I'm feeling it now. I mean, I was slow. You guys were talking about being slow to get toward to some kind of holiday feeling.
Yeah.
And when I'm out now, I have like a big smile, and I tolerate, you know, all the craziness you know, I'm just feeling like it's kind of a good time. And then I went on ronfez.net and I had to cry for like an hour.
Did you really cry from all the hate?
Yeah, it was like World War III there.
You're more sensitive than Fez, and that's saying a lot.
I think we're similar, though.
Yeah. You may actually cry more than I do.
I cry every day.
Do you really?
Yeah. Sometimes I'm washing the dishes, and I think about, like, somebody who's dead. Talking about this is making me feel like I'm right on the verge of crying.
The thing is, we almost lost Fez, too. He could have been gone.
I know. Yeah. And that would have been beyond.
But it will happen sooner or later.
Well, all of
all
us.
All life is suffering.
Yes. The Buddha said that, I think.
Yeah. We're here for pain, Bobo. And the thing is, you feel more than most, don't you?
It's impossible to achieve the aim without suffering. J.G. Bennett said that.
And he's gone now.
We're bumping our head on the way to a joke. We lost him. Lost J.G.
Yeah.
We're G.G.
That's what friends called him.
We hardly knew ye.
You want to sing a little tune for us, Bobo? Or did you just want to play in the background?
Oh, I was just noodling because I got to get my world record. I got to carry this around for 3 years.
And gotcha.
I did the flamenco, Christmas flamenco while Paulo pretended to review movies.
Yeah, he really does pretend.
Night at the museum.
If you can only see one movie over the holidays, what should it be, Paulo?
Well, I mean, obviously, you know, it looks like Clint Eastwood's pulling it out of his ass again, you know, with Letters from Iwo Jima, which is not going to be a big hit or anything because it's a very dour, depressing film. But, I mean, you know,
I like Flags of Our Fathers. Did you like that, Paul?
Yeah, I understand, but this is an entirely, totally different. I mean, I liked it.
Was he using the same shots, kind of?
No, because that was kind of almost like Saving Private Ryan, but you know, with a little more of a hopeful feeling. You know,
I didn't feel any hope. I found depression.
Well, I mean, what this film is it's just sitting on the island with the Japanese when they all know that every single one of them is going to be dead.
So it's like waiting for Godot set in World War II.
Yeah, I mean, they all know that they're basically sacrificing.
It's basically waiting for G.I. Joe. Is what they're doing.
Can I ask Paul if he saw a movie?
Yeah.
Yes.
Paul, did you see Public Witness by C.W. Prather?
No, I haven't seen that. That's our friend who has that documentary that's been at a few festivals and such. No, but I never.
What's it about, Bobo?
It's about the first G.W. Bush inauguration.
Ah.
It's really good.
Yeah, it's an interesting documentary about, and then he has the various protesters and stuff of the administration.
Yeah, egging the limo and all, you know.
Yeah, that's it's not a documentary thing, so it's very interesting. But any case, obviously there's a lot of movies over the holiday season.
If you could only see one, oh, I lost you, Paul. Call him back. Would you like that, then, you, Patty?
Funny when it happens to someone else, huh, Patty?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's good to be at the cool table.
I like the movie Sky High. That was good.
Sky High. Out of everything. Just bringing that up.
It was my favorite. Kurt Russell.
Actually, the best movie that I've seen so far from Blockbuster was the old... oh, my God, it was with
time.
Marlon Brando and Vivian Leigh, A Streetcar Named Desire.
Sure.
Yeah, it's a good Vivian Leigh.
Yeah. Well, you know,
I
it is
that.
1945. So
I heard the writer of that is gay.
Yeah, very, very gay. Oh, you could.
Hi, Tennessee. I love your bread.
Thank you.
Streetcar.
You know,
Stella.
What's going to help me is if I name myself after a state. To help me think of a gay state.
Why don't you just do that character from now on? Drop Fez because you've given it up anyway.
That's one of my favorites.
No, Fez.
You know, when that movie first came out, they banned it.
Yeah.
It was like, forget it.
So you couldn't see it opening weekend, could you?
Look who it is. It's the big TV star. Hey, Ope.
Hey, Ry. What's up, man?
You slayed last night, brother.
Yeah, I just got done with a party in Hollywood Hills.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, wow. That's awful. It's all happening now.
Who was all there?
Tom and Kate.
Oh, listen to the names dropping.
I got lunch with Steven in a little while, but I figured I'd call my old pals before I start my new life.
I knew it. I said this last night. I go, I finally see Opie really happy. You and McConaughey, I knew that was just going to open doors you didn't want to come back to anymore.
You're now a California dude.
Is that it?
It was a little weird drinking margaritas with Matthew McConaughey.
It looked odd.
I want to relate to him. Like, dude, you played bongos naked, and I did something with marshmallows once. We could relate here.
You should have gotten a Java log, buddy.
Dude, he has the biggest head I've ever seen in my life.
Do you know, one of the things about movie stars is they always do say they have large heads.
Lindsay took a picture with him. It is hilarious how much bigger his head is.
Oh, I got to see this.
By the way, meat is the devil.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, I'm just going to just randomly tell you stuff now.
Okay, right. Sure, go with it.
Meat is the devil.
Yeah.
Meat is the devil. Mm-hmm. I'm a vegan now.
Oh, he's changed everything. Everything has changed about him.
I'm just trying to figure out which meditation class that I want to start doing.
When, to tell the truth, if you had the opportunity to live in L.A., would you do it?
Oh, Ron?
Yeah.
Sell my stuff. I'm not even coming home.
No, I won't.
Just sell my stuff, take my air shift, it's over.
Now
I'm going to live on the beach. Probably Venice Beach would be great.
Now, I know you'd fit in easily. I don't see Ant making the same transition.
No, not at all. I feel very comfortable out here, that's the truth.
You look comfortable.
I watched you on Leno getting tanner and tanner as we were watching.
Let it be known, I did not go to a tanning booth. That was the makeup they chose to throw on me, I guess.
I thought it was happening under those lights, where you've always wanted to be, under those lights.
Just beaming.
Yeah.
Face it, you've always hated radio.
No, absolutely. I can't wait to leave this stupid radio thing behind. You don't think I woke up this morning checking my phone every hour hoping someone called?
that's going to take me away from this radio world.
You know, I swear to God, I don't know whether it's me because I have a way of putting things, like, you know, my own perspective. But I'm watching you guys so comfortable last night, and I go, what a fucking roller coaster ride their lives are. Just true. One minute you're down, the next you're sitting there with Jay Leno. You're having drinks. Like, how the hell could this even happen?
I don't know. Like, during the commercial break, he breaks out a blender that has, like, a lawnmower starter to it, and right. He just revs it up and starts making margaritas, and I'm like, yeah, I'm in. Ant's in. Matthew McConaughey's in. And then, like, we walk over to watch the Killers. I'm 10 feet away from the Killers just drinking a margarita with Matthew McConaughey and Anthony. I'm name-dropping.
Right.
And Anthony, like, kind of pokes me. He goes, dude, take all this in. and I did, because I don't even remember being on Letterman, so I kind of looked around and checked it all out. It was just so ridiculous. We're on the side of the stage waiting to be introduced, and I look at Anthony like, can you fucking believe this? Like, 2.5 years ago, you know, we were the dregs of society, and here we are ready to walk on to Leno.
And I swear to God, so many times I heard from people, they will never work again.
Right?
Yeah, right.
Exactly. Some of the people who hired you back, but they were right. Adamant about that.
Right. Dude, you're messing up my chi. Let's just keep it low. Let's just kind of keep it on the level. You know, don't get me too excited.
And he's going to be down at Muscle Beach later.
Opie, come home. Come home.
I do love it out here, but no, it was a lot of fun, man. And thanks for the support. I appreciate it.
Sure, bro.
The most surreal moment was Opie and seeing those guys walk past the Killers with their margarita glasses last night. It was so weird looking.
Dude, and I'm like, I'm just feeling, I'm like, hey, bro, that was great. That was a good song. I'm just like I'm turning into the host, like, good job. You want a margarita? I got to tell you, I was so pissed when Matthew McConaughey, like, took that shot at us, which was really funny about you two having sex in the church. I was ready to say, hey, man, you're the – and because everyone's like, Oprah was ready to say something, then Jay ended the segment. I was turning. It was coming out of my mouth. I was going to go, you're the one that's hanging out with Lance Armstrong.
That would have been perfect.
I think I would have had a nice laugh there, but then all of a sudden Jay ended the segment. I was so frustrated because I didn't want him to get the last laugh. But
everything really tight in TV, though, right?
Yeah,
it's segments.
I'm reading the message boards like, oh, they didn't talk about this or that. Dude, it's 7 fucking minutes.
Right.
You know? And I read the fan sites, and sometimes I wonder, is this like Howard Stern's message board? Because sometimes you don't even, you know, you don't even realize that it's your own fan sites. Because they're so fucking picky about everything.
All right. Yeah, you they know? Have no idea that it just doesn't happen that you get these invites.
Right.
It's just such an incredible long shot. It just doesn't go down this way.
Right. And, you know, Jay Leno was in our dressing room for like 20 minutes. We were shooting the shit. We had a great time. He was unbelievable. He made it so much more comfortable than Letterman. Because on Letterman, you don't even meet the guy, really. He comes over to the side of the stage, Letterman, and says hi real fast. But Leno, like, spends time in the dressing room and makes sure you're comfortable. And he wanted to talk about Baby Bird. He wanted to talk about the homeless shopping spree. But unfortunately, like you just said, the 7 minutes goes by like that, and you do what you can, you know?
I saw him do that kind of shot at Howard because Howard and him have battled back and forth, too.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He's that was frustrating. We're so sick of talking about Howard.
Right.
You know.
But I know that he set you up that way for you to take shots for him.
Right, right. Yeah.
You guys didn't buy in.
No, I mean, we're done with him. It's, you know, we had our battles, but we're doing our thing, and, you know, he's still doing his, I guess.
Yeah.
So, well, but it was unbelievable. I mean, Leno was just so cool in the end. He was so cool. And then, like, the show ends, and everyone just goes home immediately. We're hanging out, you know, in our dressing room after the appearance, and literally everyone's gone. We pretty much had to lock up the joint.
Yeah, it's just like a show. It's just like a gig for them. You're like, no. Hey, now what are we doing? Another show?
Yeah, exactly. But to them, it's just their job. So
right.
It's like, it was maybe the pinnacle of our careers. Well, certainly the pinnacle of our careers to this point. So we want to take it all in, and they're like, just another show under their belt and time to go home and get some dinner.
Hey, is Stuttering John still there, or does he just do that opening thing, or what happens?
No, he's there. He came up to us. He was nothing but cool.
Yeah.
Trash and Tom Chiasano was happy that he could
you know, kind of rub it into Tom when he left.
That's
how he
cool.
did, because Tom never gave him a raise and or respect. It was interesting getting all the inside stories yesterday.
Well, cool shit, man. You guys got over twice. You really did.
It's been a crazy year, dude.
It has been phenomenal.
Leno and, just all the stuff that happened. I just want to, you know, thank all the fans for the support. Thank you guys for the support. It's just been amazing. And I'm really excited for you guys that you're taking it to the next level now, too.
Well, what I want you to do is come home. I don't want you to stay out there.
I don't know. I'll hold on a second. Kenny.
Ron. He wants me to come home.
Hello, Star?
Kenny, would you make sure Opie comes home?
Put him on the plane.
No. We're taking in the sunshine out here.
Kenny? That place killed Belushi. I don't want to touch an Opie.
All right, now I'll keep him away from the drugs.
Nobody speedballs with him.
Listen, we got to go through Pilates now.
That's a pretty picture, Kenny.
Me and Kenny go into Rodeo Drive. We're going to get matching suits and sunglasses.
They look nice.
Yeah, you know, kind of like Rain Man. He's my Rain Man, this big and stupid guy next to me, but. All right, I'm battling. I haven't really slept, to be honest with you. We stayed out all night just having a ball.
So. All right, well, congratulations, buddy. Enjoy yourself.
Thank you, guys. Merry Christmas, and we'll see you in 07.
All right, see you soon. Bye-bye.
All right, thanks, guys. Bye.
Hey, out.
Well, Patty, there you go. Your friends have turned bigger than life now.
Cool.
Bigger than life in front of us.
I'm happy for them.
Good. Did you think that maybe you'd be part of it?
No. What do you mean? I don't know.
I would bring Patty out. Polo?
Yes, boss.
Yeah, sorry we didn't have enough time.
I understand. It's probably, I mean, Opie had a big night. It's
who?
Great.
Who did?
Opie.
Why is it so difficult to say the name Opie?
O-P-I-E. How simple can that be?
I said Opie Anthony. Opie.
Even the first two letters say his name.
Good one. Good
well,
one,
you know what you do? You just spell his name. The first two letters will say it.
Wow. She's ripping, Polo.
There you go.
It's nice. It's good. It's good for the Christmas spirit. I love you, Patty. That's all you know. This is my third or fourth favorite holiday, Christmas.
Hey, Polo.
Yeah.
Enjoy your love nest and your sinful Christmas. You deserve this.
Okay.
Yeah.
And go see Venus with Peter O'Toole. It's very good.
Is that that's the movie of the year?
No, not
the movie
of
the Christmas season?
But I would like to see him win his Oscar because he was really pissed off.
I'm a gigantic fan of Peter O'Toole's.
Yeah, he's really getting old. And he said, when they gave him the honorary Oscar the other year, he said, come on, I'm still in the running.
Right, he's like, fuck you.
Right.
My favorite year may be one of my favorite comedies of all time.
Oh, it is,
but
it is
nobody but him. I hate all the rest of the people. It's like, but Peter O'Toole was amazing in it.
I literally have that movie memorized.
All right, Paul, we'll let you go. We, got more guests coming in. Ron and Fez Show.
Ronnie. Fezzy. The Ron and Fez Show. XM 202.
Christmas ain't a holiday. A decorated tree. It ain't about the branches or a special on TV. It's a stand-in for another word. You know this secretly. I won't come out and say the word. That's your discovery. But it rhymes with glove. And you wear it on the hand of mystery. Pirates and sailors and those lost at sea. Cowboys and Indians, drunkards the free. Know what I mean, and so I Christmas thee. Doctors and dentists, those lost in a dream. Fishermen, ferrymen crossing the stream. Know what I mean, and so I Christmas thee. Know what I mean, and so I Christmas thee. While this word is secret, ain't a secret just my dreams in different names to keep from getting sick. There's nothing new beneath the sun. We've known that for a while. The film is done, the lights are up. I'll see you in the aisle. Robbers and brigands of skullduggery, criminals, vandals of dark mystery, know what I mean, and so I Christmas thee. Just John and Fallon, Pantera, Mikey, Mojo and Alice, Hot Top and Riley, Chapter and AJ, Spots and Bessie, know what I mean, and so I Christmas thee. David and Earl, Ron and Bezzy, know what I mean, and so I Christmas thee. Know what I mean, and so I Christmas thee. Say it with me now, 'cause I Christmas thee.
That was Sleeves on the Ron and Fez Show with I Christmas Thee. You can check out all his stuff at adamsmotion.com.
Oh, and look who it is, Fez, in time for Christmas.
Razzle dazzle, it's Board Gossip with Eastside Dave.
A little gossip, a little chat, a little idle talk of this.
It's Board Gossip time, starting off with Pal Talk. Word on the street is that Chemistry is shopping for a ring for Manic Mode 420. What will he do with that ring? I can't rightfully say, but my favorite Jennifer Lopez film is The Wedding Planner. The Wedding Planner.
Gotcha.
Switching over to RonFez.net, looks like even the most reliable walls can crumble. In a thread started by LunaKid23 entitled, Mikey Boy the Communist, LukaKid writes, Mikey Boy, don't lock my threads, you asshole. Your mod ship means nada to me. At which Mikey Boy said, quote, I want to jam a thumb in someone's eye. Someone just give me the reason. Oh, well, I hope Mikey Boy can find a time to stop at the deli, because RonFez.net has made him one sandwich short of a picnic.
What?
And now for Who Could It Be?
Who can it be now? Who can it be now?
What? Parody songwriter has said that after 6 years on RonFez.net, he is leaving. The reason, he says, is, quote, I don't want to say I've outgrown RonFez.net, but I've certainly outshined them. I go now to FBA. I can't tell you who this musician is, but I sure miss William Refrigerator Perry and the Dominoes Noid. I wonder, who could it be?
Not a lot of thought going into this one.
Absolutely, there's a lot of thought.
Just kind of coming into the New Year's with the wheels off?
I don't agree at all. Lots of jokes. Skipping over to Pal Talk. Have two administrators done the deed this past weekend? The gossip team overheard Monocode. Well, the gossip team overheard Monocode, also known as Anteater, because he's not circumcised, saying to those on Pal Talk, quote, I have just had sex. Meanwhile, a short time later, people overheard XOXO saying, I just made love to an anteater. Who, Joppa? It doesn't take Angela Lansbury to solve this mystery. I guess not only is Monocode an anteater, he's a woman eater as well, and XOXO is his main course.
Is everybody on that Pal Talk having sex with each other?
I believe so. I think it's just online sex chat and talk.
Thank you, Fez.
It certainly appears that way. And now it's time for a very special segment called Love Hurts.
Love hurts.
Ah.
Love starts. Love wounds.
Nazareth.
And mars. Any heart.
From FBA, it seems Flea Man has been overheard saying that he is Kara from MySpace's new boyfriend. But the gossip team has learned that, in fact, Kara's boyfriend is not Flea Man, but Natas. Guess Kara is using some flea powder because she's gotten rid of him now. Love hurts.
Love hurts. Love starts. Love wounds.
What's the second line in there? It's love hurts, then love what?
Sound like rules and Mars? I couldn't really make it up.
Go back to it again, right from the beginning. All right, ready? I never understood. All right, that's love hurts.
Love starts.
Oh, love scars.
Love
thanks.
Wounds.
I thought it was love smarts.
Certainly scarred Flea Man.
Huh?
Flea Man got his love scarred.
Oh, you're still riding this thing all the way down.
You know, your little clues are so obvious today.
And just unfunny.
Yeah. I don't agree.
So? This may be the end of this. Maybe 2007 will leave us without board gossip anymore.
Well, I hope not. And now for a segment called She Thinks She's Better Than You. From RonFizz.
What's the song for that?
Well, I tried to find one.
See, I don't want to do it. I think you got to have segments that have music.
I asked the Earl Douglas. He said there's no such song that fits that title.
I hope there's a segment called Footloose.
There's no song called Better Than You or... I just play Footloose till we come up with another song. For right now. So this is the brand new segment?
Yes, Mr. B. This segment's called She Thinks She's Better Than You.
Okay, She Thinks She's Better Than You. Yeah! Why, she thinks she's footloose, doesn't she?
From RonFez.net, Too Cute writes, stop PMing me. I don't reply to private messages, so stop sending them to me. Uchachi, maybe Too Cute, should change her name to Too Cool for School. You heard her, RonFez.net. She thinks she's better than you.
Doesn't really make her footloose.
It does, kind of, because remember in Footloose, they weren't allowed to dance?
Oh, yeah, now they're allowed to PM.
Sure. All right, here it is, for Too Cute.
Now I got a cut loose, Footloose.
Yeah. You know what? Fez can dance, even though the town he grew up in didn't let him.
Call me Willard. That's because my brother was killed on a bridge.
Well, that's today's board gossip. Remember, we're always watching.
It seemed like you didn't have a lot to say about a board that you're always fighting with, Whackbag.
There was a Whackbag story there, yes, absolutely.
I would have thought you would have ended with it for comedic purposes. You're not a big fan of Whackbag at all?
No, I'm not a big fan of Whackbag. No, yeah. that's the message board that doesn't treat me well, and I don't really care for who they are. And well, I guess the...
What is your problem with Whackbag?
Well, they always pick on me, Eastside Dave sucks at life, and they want to send my chick an inno. There's a whole bunch of things. They don't like me. There's lots of problems that I...
What the hell?
What? Oh, no.
Tony Bagels from Whackbag.
No. Oh, no.
What is he doing here at Christmas time?
Hey, Tony Bagels.
Oh, no. How's it going, Fizz?
Good, buddy.
What now?
Who would have expected a run-in on a Christmas show?
Why? On the season's greetings, maybe, but not a run-in.
Wait, what is it that you got for Eastside Dave? There's some kind of a present for Eastside Dave?
Yeah, silver bag right by you there. Well, it wasn't originally supposed to be a Christmas present.
Uh-huh.
But we waited for Earl to get back to us on when to come in. A month later, now it's Christmas time. So it's a Christmas gift for Westside. It's an inno.
Oh, an inno, that's very nice.
No. Why? Why is this going to be necessary? Well, it started originally, we started a PayPal to get the MiFi. Mm-hmm. And that was actually started by Turtle. And we wanted to
And then Death Metal Mo jumped right on board on that one. So we figured we'd get a MiFi so Westside can hear Dave.
That's, you know, it's a slight invasion. I mean, I appreciate the gift being Christmas and all, but how about something that's not gonna...
You don't want her listening to the show.
No, I don't. I don't want her hearing my things, hearing the show.
Why?
Because the relationship will be over. She doesn't need to hear things about dogs and, you know, the peanut butter and whatnot. Yeah, she'll be out of the door pretty quickly. If she gets this MiFi, you know.
We didn't get the MiFi, actually. We got an Inno so that we could put in 104 tracks of your best of, your despicable best of.
You've loaded this thing?
It's loaded. It might not be charged because it's been sitting in the bag for a month.
All right, so here's some of the stuff that is been loaded into this.
I don't appreciate, Ann Claire, if you're, well, she doesn't have a MiFi, but I don't appreciate when she leaves lots of dishes. She cooks all the time for us and doesn't do the dishes. That does upset me quite.
So there you go. So that's already been loaded in.
She doesn't need to hear that.
So you think that could start a problem?
That will give her, yeah, she'll be annoyed by that.
All right, play some more, Fez.
Like, for instance, I put on a facade with Claire. So...
Oh, that's... Right there.
See, that's not what I want.
That's the stuff you worry about.
I don't want her to hear that either.
So you're living a lie. You're living a lie, you said.
Yeah, either a lie or yeah. Mm. Well, this exposes me, I guess, so this is why, yeah, I don't really care for Whackbag to do that.
BCH, you're on Run and Fez.
Hey, how's it going, everybody?
Yeah.
You know, I'm kind of staying out of the whole East Side Dave thing, but after today... As God is my witness, that subscription never runs out.
Wow.
Oh, my gosh. You're like a philanthropist.
There's children in Africa starving. I mean, but the typical whackback.
But I will tell you this. If she hears one thing that you say about her, any of this shit from your past, you're in fucking trouble. And you shoot your pie hole off on this show.
Yes.
I can't think of any of the personal things that Eastside Dave has brought up that wouldn't have her out the door.
Normally, because it's about her.
Yeah.
And then when she came in here one time, I'm like, oh, I heard you performed oral on a chef. She started fucking crying. It's the only time we had her on here. Her heart was broke. Oh, no. I figured, because David's been saying blowjob for fucking 2 weeks every single day. I thought she already knew. I thought she was listening to the show.
Well, we had talked about it. I thought she was, I honestly thought she was cool with it myself. I was very shocked.
And Dave, when she finds out that you broadcast that you want her to call you cheese dick while you're fucking her.
Big cheese.
Cheese dick.
Oh. Big cheese.
Why cheese dick?
Yeah, would that make her mad? About all the stuff that you guys say to each other?
Yes, I will be dead.
And what was the name you call her?
I just like to her to say pussy, cunt, and big cheese. I don't really have too many names for her.
Why do you like her to say dick cheese?
I will say big cheese.
Oh.
Because it makes me feel like the boss.
Feel like the boss. That's right.
Yeah. Not the boss.
That's the right phrase.
Now it's getting a little hot.
All right, Tony, this is wonderful. You've went and put all these things, how many altogether?
104 tracks.
104?
No.
All for her to hear.
This doesn't feel like the Christmas spirit, Tony.
Well,
this doesn't feel like the way a Christmas gift should be.
See, now, I look at it another way.
Yeah.
We're giving to Whackbag, so we might not have to hear you as much because you can't shoot off of all this stuff because Westside will listen. And then also, you know, your act, like Ron had said at one point, your act will change.
Yeah, the act will change, definitely.
I don't think the act's going to change.
Because I've seen him out with his chick, and Big Bad Bill is Sweet William when he's hanging around with her. He just walks that line. Now let me ask you three guys this. Have you snooped on your chick?
Yeah, oh yeah.
What do you do?
I just do a typical, I sit in my car outside to make sure, you know, her bedroom light is off and... If I see it on, I get upset.
Okay, what about you? Because she might be up reading.
This feels like this should be illegal. This feels like it was a wiretap.
This would have been a perfect present for me. I could just sit at home and listen to you sticking your damn foot in your mouth one after another. Now, this girlfriend of yours that you hide everything from, does she know that you're getting lap danced?
Oh, no. Ah! She didn't know about that. I was quite actually happy at the phenomenal security of Flash Dancers for confiscating this kid's camera. Okay, you know,
I love this.
No.
This might be my favorite Christmas ever.
I don't think it is. Now it's starting to get a little frightening here, okay? I thought there was going to be a couple fun little clips. This is serious relationship drivers.
Hey, Ron?
Yeah.
I just want to put this one thing forward from an earlier show. I don't even know if Dave remembers it, but you could check the tapes. He also said that he doesn't really care if she gets hers. He just, as long as he's, you know, gotten his...
Are you talking about sexual climax stuff?
Exactly.
I don't think I said... Well, if I did, fine. Who had... What the fucking 87% of guys are like that.
I'm sure you said it.
This is the girl you're going to marry, though. You got to treat her with a little respect.
I give her a fucking solid 12 minutes every single time. I mean, that's pretty damn good.
12 minutes of what?
Sex.
Yeah, but what about the rest of your life?
I take out the trash. She never takes out the trash. She doesn't like touching it. I always take out the trash. I do the dishes. Sure, she cooks every day. And she has to lug my laundry to the laundromat. That she's not pleased about that. But besides that, I contribute. I make her laugh. I make her smile.
So you load the dishwasher, and that way you get to fuck dogs. That's the fair trade-off there.
This is really going bad.
You know what I like is that time it sounds like Fez is going to make her cry. I want to be here when she listens. Please, this is what I'm begging you for Christmas.
Yeah.
Let me look at her poor face as it changed from happiness to getting a nice gift to the realization, having the curtain pulled back on her life and seeing that she's living with a douchebag.
This can't happen anymore.
Jared, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Yeah.
Hey, I don't think Michael Corleone was such a douche that he named his cock Friendly.
You don't know that. You can't show everything in a movie, pal.
Friendo.
Yeah.
I don't think that's going to happen. Well, Turtle, we thank you very much. It's lovely, lovely.
Thank you, buddy.
Love that one.
Yeah, I really hope that this... Can I... What if I keep the info for myself?
That wasn't...
It's not going to happen. It's not a present for you.
Actually, you know, since we burn them to CD as well, it can be a constant flow of CDs until West Side hears all 104 tracks.
Maybe you apologize to Whack Bag with your ass out. You stand here with your ass out and you apologize to Whack Bag.
You don't think this is a slight invasion of privacy in a way? She doesn't
public mean... airwaves. This is public airwaves.
Well, is it really? Satellites?
Yes.
Hey, I wanted to losing the memories, you know, with more and more drinking. I've been sober 3 years now, and I'm getting all the memories from 10 and below back. But I changed my mind because he's a fucking freak. I've been very drunk and very just very messed up, and I would never have considered any of these things.
There is not enough alcohol in the world to get most people a fucking animal. It ain't gonna happen. Zookeepers don't do it when they're drunk.
You didn't see this husky. Just before everyone makes up their mind, it was a
lie detector. Because people think he lies. I want a lie detector in here.
I'd love it. I would love it, and then I want some cash or money, or I want to be called...
You want to be proven right in this, that you fucked a dog.
I want to be called King of Truthfulness.
Aren't you embarrassed about that?
I am somewhat ashamed, but I'm not really.
Ashamed?
Ashamed, because I feel like the dog has a snack and...
You know what? If we were a civilized country, we'd all throw rocks at you till you were dead. That's what's wrong with this country.
Tony, what happened? Well, I mean, at the Christmas party, we were smiles, we were hugging.
Why? This is a beautiful present for your girlfriend.
I don't see it that way, Mr. B. I see it as a relationship sabotage.
I wouldn't call it hugging. We, like you said, it was a 24-hour peace.
Reprieve, a little reprieve.
We didn't want to make a scene at the .NET party that would drag them into it and make it all ugly.
Oh, that place was a scene. Mikey Boy worked his magic that night. Nothing but trouble.
Did you mean that you shoved the bottle of Prel up your ass? Is that what you mean?
That makes sense then.
No, that never happened.
Are you an ass man?
No. I'm not going to say it hasn't crossed my mind. I mean, not like Fender Music Jeff, maybe a finger or something I've always thought might be pleasurable, or maybe the butt plug or something. But
how is this pertinent to her at all?
Why? Let her just listen.
Wait, why would she need to hear that?
That her boyfriend wants a butt plug.
She doesn't need to hear that. If you're talking about things that I've said about her, at least I can understand. This is...
Let her hear everything. I want to know who she's with. Jeff, you're on Run and Fez.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Yeah.
What else is Dave going to do? You know, if I put fur around my mail slot around the apartment, so while he's drunk, will he fuck the mail slot too?
Well, he has jerked off in many, many... Well, he jerked off in Plymouth Rock, right?
Wasn't
that you?
Uh-huh.
Plymouth Rock and Statue of Liberty and probably Grand Canyon are my greatest conquests of spanking it.
More than the dog?
More than the dog. I mean, yeah, I'm not embarrassed to say that. You know, we've heard my story. I fucked a blow-up doll, and fucked a jar of microwave jelly, like, one time, but that's all.
You microwaved the jelly first?
Yeah, because trust me...
You kept a lid off of it, right?
Yes.
Good.
To people who are curious out there, it does work. It's the best simulation to sex that I've come up with.
Now, had you read about it somewhere, or you invented this?
It was my own thing. I really had a good thought. I emptied the jelly with halfway... microwaved it. It's got to be Welch's grape jelly.
Not too hot.
Hot because I learned that because I did burn my cock when I first put it in.
Oh, no.
But you have to do it missionary style, and it works. It works the best.
Missionary style? What other way is there to fuck a jar? To come at it from behind, you idiot?
I picked it up, and I tried to do doggy, but it spilled all over the carpet.
So you've got to lay the jar down. That's what
you have to lay the jar down.
I don't know what missionaries were spreading this fucking behavior to people. I have a hard time to believe the Catholic Church would say, now when banging a jar of jelly, make sure you don't put it in your hands.
Hey, the way I look at it...
There it is. There's your Welch's.
This is right, perfect.
Show us. No, without... put the lid back on, because other people are going to eat this. Yeah. How would you approach this jar?
I would take the jelly...
Yeah.
Put it on the ground.
Yeah.
And after microwaving it, you know, boom, up and down,
now,
thrusting the way you would to a woman.
Now, the odd thing
is... up and down.
This is way less offensive to me than the dog.
Yeah.
The jar, this is a fucking idiot with a jar. I don't care.
I would
That's his business. The dog completely grosses me out.
Yeah.
And I find unforgivable.
Okay, well, that's where you and I differ, you know? Oh, boy. Well, that's good. So, you know, to all the single ladies out there, when she gets this, you know, gift, that's it for me.
Not going to happen for you anymore.
No.
You know, out of everything, I don't know why this is, the dog, you know. For some reason, the thing that really offends me right now is you jacking off on Plymouth Rock. I don't know why that bothers me. I don't know whether it's because it's historic or the fact that children go there to look at it. But running a batch on Plymouth Rock just seems absolutely wrong.
Well, it's a historic monument, so I wanted a piece of me on it forever. Like, I wanted myself to be a part of history. That's the logic behind that in the Grand Canyon.
Oh, there's logic to this.
Yeah. You know, there I'm there forever now. There's a piece of me at the Grand Canyon.
Well, maybe, you know, if you want to be a piece of history, maybe after she gets this gift, you'll be history on the airwaves. I know the guys at the listening thread really want that.
Thank you, Tony. Jesus.
Here's Chris. Chris, you're in Run of Fez.
Hey, good afternoon, guys. Hey, listen, Dave, you know, not for nothing. At least this, if they give her the, you know, at least this will get you Worst Boyfriend of the Year award.
That might happen for
That's
you.
Not the award I was looking for.
That might happen. Here's Clay. Clay, you're on Run of Fez.
Yeah, how's it going, guys?
Yeah.
Hey, I just want to back Dave up here a little bit. I want to say, you know, and I personally, I can't believe that I'm saying this because I'm not the biggest fan, Dave. No offense, but
okay.
I got to say that this is some sort of guy code I feel is being broke here, man.
Yeah, do you, Tony, do you think that Whackbag has broken the guy code?
Well, originally it was started to, we just wanted an apology from Dave from his attack when he, right after his drunken 60 shots or whatever, his
61,
attack.
Roger Maris, baby.
You know that the home run record's
why you're bragging.
Okay. The record's not 61 anymore.
Well, I had already been hated by Whackbag, and then the one girl called me, you know, all these names under the sun, and she shook my hand, and then post what a dirtbag I am. Dirtbag. I mean, well, why use such a phrase, Mr. B?
I can't think of anything better for you. Dirtbag is exactly what you are.
I don't think that's...
Jelly fucker.
And the thing is, so, you know, we want to make amends in 2007. All the websites extend a hand to Whackbag. Why this is necessary.
We
want to
make amends?
Make amends to Whackbag.
He just says make amends all the time. Let's see what Stink Bomb thinks. Stink Bomb.
Merry Christmas, you filthy animals. And a Happy New Year.
Nice, Stink Bomb. Beautiful. It's like an audio Christmas card from Stink Bomb.
Like one of those Hallmarks that you open up. It's got the little computer chip in it.
Eric, you're on with Ron and Fez Show. How are you, buddy?
Hey, what's up, Ron? Hey, Fez, how you doing?
Good.
I think maybe Dave should apologize, but in a different fashion. Tony Bagels, I think you should make Dave get on his hands and knees and make it sound sincere and let the whack bag take a vote on if it's sincere enough. And if it's sincere enough, maybe let him have a pass. And if it's not, then the inner goes to Westside. What do you think, Tony Bagels?
That's not a bad idea. I wouldn't mind hearing Dave sitting here groveling. I mean,
would you be willing to grovel?
Maybe apologize, maybe.
You gotta do it on your hands and knees, Dave, to be a real apology. With your ass out.
Okay, then forget it. When you throw in the ass clause, I'm just not game for
Why
that.
Why can't you take your ass out and apologize?
Because I'm not gonna do that.
Alright, you got two choices. You're on your hands and knees apologizing, and the, you know, doesn't get, passed on. Or you're standing up like a man, with your ass out and apologizing.
I don't want to apologize on my hands and knees, so that's a little groveling. If I could shake Tony's hand and say, hey.
That wasn't the choice. So if you can't do it, you can't do it. She gets it, and off we go.
All right, I'll go on my hands and knees.
All right, I want to bring everybody into the room to see this happen, though. Everybody, come on
in. No, you know what? I'll go on my ass. If they're going to come in, can I then do my ass?
I don't. You know, Dave, if you could just make it worse radio, I would love it.
Okay.
But it doesn't matter either way. You want to stand with your ass out and apologize, that's okay with me. But hold on. Now, Tony, would you be willing, because I still think she should get the NO. You can't take gay a present away from her, but would you be willing to erase the bits that you have? That's up to you.
Well, I'd have to take it back and then get it back. That by doing that, then it would probably be another month or so before I hear back from an email from Earl when we can come back.
What? Earl, don't fuck up anymore, okay? Just do me a favor.
Yes, I won't.
Thank
you. Anymore.
Yes, I won't.
What if I just erased him? Is that okay? I mean, or Earl erased him?
Well, before I say yes or no, I'd really like to hear an apology.
Okay.
All right. Now, here comes the ass out. Patty, you be right there.
No.
Patty, you be next to it. Be
that's
right next
net.
To it. Yeah.
This is, oh, you my. I don't know why Nosferatu has to be looking at me through the glass. That's kind of fucking weird.
Why not?
Me.
Where's
now
the
here,
camera?
Now, yeah.
And piss, too.
And the apology has to last for a full minute.
Well, I will.
No balls out.
I know. I didn't
just
do that.
Comfortably have your ass out. And
what do you want me to say?
Give him some sad music, Fez.
All right.
You need for a full minute to apologize to Whackbag for the way that you've been the last year.
I apologize to Whackbag for the things that I've said. Some of them may have been misconstrued, and some of them heartfelt. But in the end, we all make mistakes. And I, Eastside Dave, made plenty of them. And 2006 was a bad year. A year for mistakes. And I do apologize with a lot of passion to Whackbag. And I hope that I don't suck at life. But I hope you see me as someone who does pretty darn good at life. Because that's the way I feel. So in the end, I'd like to say to Whackbag, please accept this apology on behalf of the ghost of Christmas past, present, future, and on the holiday season. And please know that I am sorry for the things I've done, and let's move forward in 2007.
With the ass out!
That was my arthroscopic
20 points.
No, the arthroscopic knee. That was the arthroscopic knee.
Christmas bells are ringing.
I'm not shitting you. There's two scars there.
Let me see. I didn't know. Oh, no.
Ow! Pain! So was that accepted?
That was very, very nice, Tony.
That was heartfelt. I mean, it almost sounds like you are used to apologizing. How many times a day do you apologize to Westside?
No, I really meant those words. I've seen some of the errors of my ways. Not all.
Some of them. That's nice, though. Here he is. He's putting a hand out of Christmas, Fez.
And an ass.
How's the knee?
The knee is, I had to get arthroscopic surgery on it, and now it's bubbling up again.
Old jack-off injury that you had over the years?
Ran that into Plymouth Rock.
Baseball, Mr. B, baseball.
Seriously, make me a promise you'll stop fucking Plymouth Rock. Please.
I can't promise. We take another family trip up there. What else am I supposed to
You're
do?
You're 29. Stop taking family trips. Do your parents a favor and let them get into old age without you hanging around like an elderly retard, just draining them of every cent they have.
I love family trips, though. I get to get M&M's out of the mini fridge and everything. It's...
Yeah.
Golly, it's fun.
Hold on. Dugout Doug is here. Doug, how are you, buddy?
I'm doing great until about 2 minutes ago. Dave, what the fuck did you just do?
I just want to keep a relationship afloat. It doesn't mean I still don't love FBA.
You brought shame.
Doug.
We threw our arms open to you, Dave. You're moderator of the year. You know that?
Oh, thank you.
You're going to be FBA moderator of the year.
So I got an award. Yes.
You apologize to those pigs?
Hey, Doug, between me and you, desperate times call for desperate measures. I mean, you know.
You'll blow it. You're out.
You did an ass-out apology.
You're out.
I'm not out, Doug. Don't take this away from me. These past few months have been the golden years of my life. I love FBA.
Everybody has seen the hottest girls on FBA pictures. If West Side sees this and takes it bad, you come to me, I give you one of those girls. That's how it works.
Wait, if why don't I just... Here, if Fez could hit that music,
yeah.
I have another ass-out apology to make.
Yeah, okay, take out the ass.
And this is I'm doing an ass-out apology to my friends at MBA.
For some reason, you're empty in the room, and I think it's because guys want to see your ass through the window. They are so disgusting. We have the worst friends ever.
Doug, I have my ass out apologizing to FBA for the whackbag apology. And I hope that... Yeah.
I want to hear one thing, Dave.
Yes, sir.
Fuck whackbag.
Fuck whackbag.
Oh,
fuck in the hell! Take it!
And
the
Eno gets delivered.
Yeah. And good, then, I'm glad. You know, gets delivered.
Fine. Do what you will. Do what you will. I tried my hardest. I tried to make things happen.
Did you really?
I did.
All I saw you do is drop your pants.
Yeah, that's a shameful thing. That's like a scarlet letter. I did what I could. I
letter fucking Q. There's something wrong with you.
Not only did I bear my...
Your asshole's an Audi. There's something seriously wrong with you.
Not only did I bear my soul, I bared my ass. And I think that counts for something.
That is disgusting. Jimmy, you're on Ron and Fez. Hold on. Jimmy, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, what's up, buddy?
Yeah.
Dave, how could you apologize to them? I've lost all respect for you, my friend.
Yeah, you lost all your FBA friends, and well, you should have. Hey, James. James, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, guys. I just am really shocked at these whackbaggers. Why would they want to wreck this guy's relationship? I hate Dave just as much as they do, but this is sociopathic. Like, what?
Why? What's the problem with it?
Why are they so hooked on Dave and hating him so much that they want to hurt this girl who hasn't done anything to them?
This is the thing, though. Yes, we all like to hurt Dave. But this, you know, it's almost like Whackbag is taking her out on a fishing trip, and while she's saying the Hail Mary, they're smashing her in the back of the head with this, you know. She is Fredo of this story.
Yeah, she's an innocent. There's no reason for her to be involved in collateral damage.
There's no reason for her to be involved in you. She needs to find out the real you, and this is going to do it.
Fine.
And I'm glad you've been red dotted from from FBA. You're done with them too.
No, I'm not done with them. I gave them an apology for the whackbag apology. There are things called temporary insanity.
By the way, we also have an apology from, and this is a big one. This one's going to ronfez.net. It's a beautiful apology from Alki. Alki has an apology for us. And that means a lot to me, Fez, that Alki, after all this time, is ready to say to Mikey Boy and Just John and Bobby Pantera, Riley, the whole gang at ronfez.net that he's sorry.
I have no problem with Riley. Luck, I don't even know who the fucking cunt is, but for any of those fucking mods to fucking ban me over some bitch that has been around for 4 fucking months takes a lot of fucking balls. And for Mikey Boy to give me a fucking message that says, I'm too tired right now, I'll deal with you in the morning, fuck that shit. Fuck that. You deal with me now. I only fucking call in, I only fucking answer the show, I've only been friends with fucking Eastside Dave for 6 fucking years. For me to fucking be pushed aside and to still be banned in the morning is bullshit. Is absolute fucking horseshit. I don't fucking matter. Like, I don't fucking add anything. Some people that come out to those fucking Ron and Fez fucking parties come out and fucking want to say hi to me.
That is true. It's the only reason we've ever had a good party is because of Alki. That is a beautiful, beautiful apology. I'm glad everything is behind us now. All right, Tony, Claire is getting the, you know, there's nothing we can do about it. He had an apology. His friends at FBA made him unapologize, and he did that.
Yeah,
I wish you wouldn't apologize in the first time with your ass out. And every guy here who ran out of the room to look at his ass through the window, you disgust me. Not one of you is my friend anymore. I can't imagine running out of a room to see a man's ass. Only Patty stayed. Only Patty didn't want to see that ass. Tony, thanks for all the presents. We'll open them up. Thanks, everybody at Whack Bag. We'll take a break. We'll be right back. Ron and Fez Show.